survey says it's 6 o'clock. Time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Excited tonight. Hi everybody, welcome to Family Feud, where tonight one of these families might take home $10,000 and be in the running to win a brand new Mitsubishi Outlander. And it's just by guessing some top answers to some easy questions. So let's meet them. Now first up, would you please welcome back our champs on their fourth night from Victoria, the Murray family.
Victoria, how uncanny. Christine, welcome.
Thank you. Remind
Australia, who's on board this wonderful team of yours?
My husband Ben, my sister-in-law Emily and my brother-in-law Rob.
And one night away from the car too, I might add. And ready to take them on tonight from WA, it's the Dierckx family. How are you, Jake?
I'm good, thank you.
Who have you hand-selected?
Whoa, it was a tough pick. But I brought Jess, my sister, my brother Matt and my dad Darren.
Fantastic. Welcome on board. Team captains, round one. Let's go to Feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. What do you think is the most time-saving device of the 21st century? Yes, Jack?
Phone.
The phone would be. Yay! Pass or play? Hi, Jess.
Hi, Grant.
How are you going?
Good, thanks.
What do you think is the most time-saving device of the 21st century?
Well, I think with my job, I'm in an office, I would say computer.
Yeah, good answer. Is it on the board? What's a carpetologist?
Oh, it's a carpet layer.
A carpetologist. Is that a title that you came up with?
Pretty much.
Yeah, that's awesome. I like that. It's inventive. What do you think is the most time-saving device of the 21st century, Matt?
Internet.
The internet. Whee! How are you, Darren?
Not bad, Grant.
Great to have you on board, mate. Thanks. What do you think is the most time-saving device of the 21st century?
It's old, but I'd say it's still the 21st. Fax machine.
Let's see if a fax machine is there. No, it's not. First strike. That's okay. Ooh. Hey, Jake.
Tablet.
Like,
yeah.
Mm. Like an iPad sort of tablet device.
Tablet.
Tablet. Ooh, two strikes. Righto. The Murray's good. Steal here, Jess.
Pressure's on.
What do you think is the most time-saving device of this modern era of ours?
Again, another thing I use at work is email.
Yeah, I like that answer. Let's see if this survey agrees. No, it doesn't, Dierckx. Righto, Murray family. Rob, what would you say?
The humble family car.
Cool. Emily?
Microwave.
Nice. Ben?
I'm microwave as well.
Yep, Christine?
What would we do without our microwave?
What would we do? Yeah! Murray's on the board. Remaining answers. Dishwasher. GPS.
Washing machine.
All of them are handy because they do all the work for us. Right, let's take a look at the scores right now. So 72 for the Murrays, early days yet for the Dierckx, so no problem. If you're going to win for 5 nights, and you know you're on your 4th night tonight, Murray family, but on the 5th night, if you win, you'll be taking home the amazing all-new Mitsubishi Outlander. This great-looking SUV has room for 5, it's got touchscreen audio, Bluetooth phone system, plus safety features like 7 airbags and a reversing camera as well. Now, here's a question for everybody playing along at home. I want the top answer to this one. Name an activity you do lying down. We'll see what everybody says when we come back after this. Feud. Before the break, I asked, name an activity you do lying down. The top answer was...
Sleep!
Sleep, it certainly is. I wonder if that was the answer in every member of the household's mind. Right now, our families are still locked in a battle as they play for $10,000 right now. So, Ben and Jess, let's play the Feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something people choose very carefully. Benjamin.
Cars.
Let's see if you're right. Can you beat it, Jess?
The outfit.
Let's see. Woo! Oh, close one. Pass it, pass it.
Pass. The pass.
You guys are going to play. Name something people choose very carefully.
Their children name.
Their children. Great answer. Darren.
Their house.
Let's see if it's on the board. Nice job.
I'm going to go with their partner.
Love the answer. Is it on the board? Top job. What about you, Jess?
Well, I'm thinking job.
Choose your job carefully.
Yes.
Let's see if the survey agrees. Oh. It doesn't. It's the first strike only, though. Matt, got something?
Not yet.
Well, I'll give you 3 seconds.
Yeah.
The food they eat. Food.
It's a last second answer, too. That's two strikes, so the Murrays could potentially steal, Darren. Speaking of choosing very carefully here, you proposed to your second wife, how?
Well, we'd actually just got some news at the doctor's that we had someone coming along.
Good.
So I was going to propose to her the following week, and I thought, no, I'll hurry up and propose to her now, so I dragged her into town, went and picked up the ring and left her standing in the middle of the Hay Street Mall, got down on one knee. The clock struck 12. I thought, this will be romantic. And then, Messina. Oh, sorry, I mean Del. Will you marry me? Messina is their mother. Delisa is his mother.
Let me just clarify. You proposed to your second wife using your first wife's name.
Yep.
And she said yes?
Not that first, no.
Somehow you recovered the situation, though.
And been together for over 21 years.
Let's hear it for that. Boy, you are lucky. Name something people choose very carefully.
They're friends.
Ooh, love the answer. Third strike, I'm afraid. Murray, Rob.
Fruit and veggies?
Emily.
I reckon there's nothing worse than getting a bad haircut. So I'm going to say hairdresser.
You choose your hairdresser.
Yeah, very carefully.
Ben. Engagement rings.
Love it. Christine.
Well, that's probably one of a biggest decision other than, you know, your house and your partner, maybe the engagement ring.
That's the third biggest thing in your life.
You are such a lady.
What about for the steal? Give me engagement ring. Right now. So, Emily, Matt, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something a dentist puts in your mouth. Emily?
Airbrush. To get rid of the saliva. They do, really.
An airbrush?
Yeah, like a...
Just in case you want, a mural done in the back of your mouth?
Yeah. Exactly.
It's like a landscape, thank you, dentist. Might be a bit of a sunrise and a tree.
Yeah.
Just painted on the tonsils.
Yeah.
What about airbrush?
Oh. Woo!
An air thingy.
Yeah, it's something
air.
Air
thingy.
Yep.
Matt.
I'm going to go with God. The thing that you... Like, once you have, a tooth out, you've got to put the gauze in your mouth.
Oh, the gauze. The gauze. Is that what it's called?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, no. Emily. Darren, something a dentist puts in your mouth.
A drill.
Of course he does. And don't we love him for it? Smile.
Smile?
Yeah, it's lovely.
Yeah.
Divine. You have a beautiful smile, very straight teeth.
Braces.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, mum and dad's money.
Did you ever kiss like someone else and get like locked together?
Oh, no, I wouldn't date someone with braces.
That's classic. Name something a dentist puts in your mouth.
A mirror.
A mirror. Oh, we have a good time, don't we, Jess?
Yes.
We have a great time. Name something a dentist puts in your mouth.
A filling?
Yeah. Filling. Oh, what? I don't know. I didn't do it. Matt.
Tooth?
They put it... Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So they can take them out and they can put them back in again.
Yeah. Don't see why not.
You're a great thinker. What about teeth? Oh, I love your answers, though. Murray family could steal. Darren.
A needle.
Makes a lot of sense. Is it on the board? Name something a dentist puts in your mouth.
Their hands. You know, when they're talking to you and they're trying to get you to answer and you can't.
Their hands. Yes. Do you hate the dentist?
I hate the dentist.
Does anybody like the dentist?
No, surely not.
I don't mind it.
Do you really?
Yeah.
What's the good part about going to the dentist?
I don't know. You're going to stick their hands in your mouth and...
Yes, what you're into?
No.
Jess.
I'm thinking like a cap, like on your tooth. Like if you've chipped it or something, they put a cap.
They put a cap on your tooth. Three strikes. A lot of fun, though, Dierckx. Murray. Murray family. Rob.
A toothbrush.
Toothbrush? Well, you just go in there and have them clean your teeth for you. Hey, no, I can't be bothered doing this before work today. Would you mind having a crack for me? Emily.
I think mouthwash, probably.
Yep.
Yeah.
Cool. So after they've done all the gear,
you rinse it out
in the bowl.
Yep.
Ben.
I reckon the little hook thing that they scrape your teeth with.
Oh! Yeah. That's right. Christine.
Oh, I don't know.
Mouthwash.
Hook thing, mouthwash. Come on, audience.
Bite.
Mouthwash was my first answer.
Mouthwash? We're going with mouthwash for the steal. Give me mouthwash. Ah! Oh! We're all hanging for the answers now. Eight. Wooden stick. A light. Let's look at the scores. 148 to the Murray family to 124 to the Dierckx family. This is a ripper game tonight. Enjoy watching Family Feud, then why not play along with our official Family Feud game? Just head to 10 Play and all the details are right there. After the break, our families are playing for triple points. Yeah, it just gets better. We'll be back after this. The Dierckx family on 124, but it's the Murray family on their fourth night who have it on 148. It is very, very close. You know what? The family who gets to 300 points in this round is going to win the game, and we're playing for triple points now, everybody. Righto, Rob, Darren, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people, and the top seven answers are on the board. What is something most people do not miss about high school? Rob.
Homework.
Yeah, homework. Pass or play?
Pass, play. Good play.
I'm really sensing some strategy being played by the Murray family.
We broke the strategy.
Yeah. You've decided to play this time where you've been doing a lot of passing. Why is that?
Someone didn't listen.
Didn't follow that rule.
What's something most people do not miss about high school?
Teachers. Not mine. Yeah. Good.
Mathematics.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah, that's right. Oh. First strike. Emily.
What I think wearing a uniform.
Yeah, you're over that by the end of it?
Yeah, 7 years of that.
Over wearing a uniform.
I think they're over... The thing I miss the most is bullying, or bullies.
Yeah, yeah.
Bullies.
Yeah, I hear you. Damn you, bullies.
Look who's on television now, bullies. Boom. What's something most people do not miss about high school?
Oh, I like bullies, actually. Now I've got to think of something different. The friends that they had might not see them ever again after high school, so what maybe I'm not missing my friends. What?
I'm sure they'd love to hear that right now.
Show me friends on the board. Oh. Second strike. Ben, triple points round right now. Two strikes down. What's something most people do not miss about high school?
I'm really hoping sports up there.
You don't miss having to do sports. Oh. I thought that was a good one. Dierckx family, hello. Triple points round. Darren.
Exams.
Love that. Matt.
Detention.
Excellent. Jess.
I think exams.
And Jake.
I'm going to go with the majority.
Exams. You currently trail the competition. You will lead and become our brand new champions if we can knock this off the board.
Fingers
so
crossed.
You're saying?
Exams.
Exams. How do we feel about that? Yeah. To crown you new champions, is exams on the board? Play. It's goodbye to the Murray families. Christine, Ben, Emily, and Rob, everyone. Now, the somewhat sad sideline to your story is what you've
I think attempts. I need all my friends.
That, and you didn't quite take home the fast money round on any of your attempts, but did you have fun?
We had a great time.
We're going to make sure you don't go home empty-handed. Of course, you did get $10 for every point in the fast money round, and not only that, you'll get a gift card for $1,000 from Showcase Jewelers, your local independent jeweller. So the Murray family, everybody. Well, Dierckx, who's playing fast money?
It's me. Come on over.
Super excited?
Yeah.
Right on. Pumped. So you're going to go in our soundproof booth. That's back that way. We're going to talk $10,000 in 20 seconds. Can you do it?
I hope so, for my sake.
Yes, he can. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back after this.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Champs right now, welcome back for the Fast Money Round. Look, if you and Jake get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000. And Jake is currently now in our soundproof booth and doing some smooth, slick manoeuvres. I'm going to give you 5 questions and 20 seconds to answer those 5 questions. Now, if you pass, we'll come back if there's time. And the clock starts at the end of the very first question. You ready?
Yep.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Best of luck. Name an ingredient you'd find in Mexican food.
Chili.
Name something you see on a window ledge.
Flowers.
What's the best remedy for a common cold?
Cough syrup.
Name a fruit you never buy just one of.
Grapes.
Name something you might see in front of a house.
A car.
Pretty good answers. Good job, let's go. Name an ingredient you'd find in Mexican food. You said? Chile. Survey says. Wow. Name something you see on a window ledge. You said? Flowers. The survey says. 55. What's the best remedy for a common cold? You said? Cough syrup. Survey says. 7. Name a fruit you never buy just one of. You said? Grapes. The survey says. Name something you might see in front of a house. You said? A car. The survey says. Okay. Over the halfway mark. Brilliant. Head back to the family. Clear the board. Welcome back, Jake.
Thank you.
Enjoy your time in there.
Oh, it's lovely.
Over half the work has been done, so you only need 90 points for $10,000. I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions, but I'll give you an extra 5 seconds on the clock, OK? And if you give me the same answer as Darren, you'll hear this sound,
and I'll ask you to try again. And if you say pass, we'll come back if there's time too, okay? Yep. Can we remind everybody of Darren's answers and 25 seconds on the clock too, please? Time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck.
Okay.
Name an ingredient you'd find in Mexican food.
Chili.
Try again.
Tomato.
Name something you see on a window ledge.
Plants.
What's the best remedy for a common cold?
Cough medicine.
Try again.
Oranges.
Name a fruit you never buy just one of.
Oranges.
Name something you might see in front of a house.
Garden.
Excellent work. Let's go. Name an ingredient you'd find in Mexican food. You said tomato. The survey says three. Now, the top answer was chili. And Darren had that. Name something you see in a window ledge. You said plants. The survey says 17. Now, Darren also had that, flowers. So we need 70 now for $10,000. What's the best remedy for a common cold? You said oranges?
Maybe.
Survey says four. If you had said rest or sleep, you would have had the top answer.
Ugh.
So we need 66 for $10,000. Name a fruit you'd ever buy just one of. You said?
Oranges. Is a theme.
The survey says... two. Grapes was the top answer. So Darren had three top answers and he's cracking opening round. How would you describe yours so far?
He stole all my answers, you know?
How rude.
I should have gone first.
We need 64 for $10,000. Name something you might see in front of a house. I thought you were going to say orange tree. You said a garden. We need 64 or more for $10,000. The survey says... A little short, Jake. Not $10,000, but you do get $10 for every fast money point. So, yay for that. And I'll be back again next time for another shot at $10,000. Thanks for watching, everybody. Join us again tomorrow night where we all play Family Feud. And stay tuned now for the project. It's news for all the family. I'm Grant Denyer. Good night, Australia.